Make a new document. Center the artboard. Make sure you have no fill and only stroke selected. Make a circle. Center it. Click Shift and Alt and drag the circle out till it meets the outer rim. Hit Ctrl R on the anchor point and type in 15 degrees and hit copy, and then repeat it with Ctrl D. Now you have to do is each point where the circle intersects, you have to have a circle there. Now make a copy of the circle and resize it. Use the zoom tool to zoom in and hit Ctrl Y to go to outline mode to make it more visible. Now hit the scroll wheel of your mouse and get it down to a smaller size and keep it like that. You have to be able to put it as close as possible. You'd have to be very precise to get the perfect effect. See, if needed be, you have to zoom in further. To make smaller adjustments, you have to hold down the control key to make smaller adjustments. Again, hit Ctrl C and Ctrl F and again resize the wheel. Each and every junction where the circle intersects, you have to have a circle there. That's how this effect works. While holding down the Shift key, if you move the scroll wheel, it will jump much faster. You have to make micro adjustments or smaller increments. Hold down the Control key. Try to be as precise as possible during this process, because that will make the effect more realistic. That's your basic design. Now it's time to color. Select everything and go to Live Paint and select the foreground color as black. You can hit X to invert the colors and make the selected color black and start filling. Zoom in. If you make a mistake, hit Ctrl Z to go back and redo it. You will have to do this in white also. It will make it easier if you use a colored background. Now do the same process with the white color. To see whether you have covered everything, what you can do now is move the entire design out of the artboard from the white artboard background to the gray area. So this will give you a lot easier view to see if you have missed any spot. This will be made a lot easier if you use a colored background. See, I missed a spot here. Let's play with the color and choose color. Here I'm going to choose red and make sure you have the arrow selected so it will change color. I'm going to choose yellow for the white instead of the white and so on. You can choose whatever color you want. Let's choose yellow for the white instead of the white and so on. You can choose whatever color you want. That's your basic design.